This video shows some practical examples of how to use collision detection in ARCHICAD. This functionality is now part of the ARCHICAD software package, so there is no need to install any add-on or extension. The following example will demonstrate how to check the escape route of a building. We'll check to see if all doors along the escape route meet the necessary fire rating requirements. In this design project, the escape route runs through the staircase, so we need to check all the doors located here. Let's consider that the doors must also withstand a fire for at least 60 minutes. The fire resistance rating of all the doors was entered during the design development. Let's check this for a selected door. This value is visible in minutes on the Classification and Properties tab page of the Door Settings dialog. Thanks to collision detection, we do not need to check all the doors manually, one by one. We can check all the doors in one step. Collision detection can save valuable time when we need to perform similar tasks in larger design projects. Let's see how this works. The collision detection dialog displays two panels, Group 1 and Group 2. We may define criteria using the Add option. Criteria sets enable us to collide only the necessary design elements. If we would like to use multiple criteria within a group, then we recommend opening ARCHICAD's Find and Select function. Here we can specify multiple criteria for the collision detection criteria group. The criteria saved by Find and Select are stored in the My Criteria set. This can be displayed using the arrow icon next to the Add button. Only those elements specified here will be detected for collisions later. Therefore, this can be used as a filter in addition to criteria. Once the criteria sets are defined for the groups, we can start collision detection using the check button. We'll use ARCHICAD's 3D zones to identify the doors located along the escape routes. The escape routing zone has also already been created and inserted in the design to the relevant places on all stories. Let's have a look at the floor plans. We would like to create a new property entry for the classification and property data of the zone element. This new property will be used to identify those zones which run along the escape route. Later on, this property will also be used as criteria for collision detection. Let's open the Property Manager to specify a new property entry. Please note that there's a dedicated video that focuses on ARCHICAD's Property Manager. Let's add a new zone to the list and enter escape route validity for its name. Let's specify the true/false option for the data type and set the preview default value to false. Let's display the availability for classification panel and select the custom space option. Click OK to apply all the changes. Now we'll open the settings dialog of those zones located along the escape route. Please note that the zone list on the Classification and Zone panel now displays the escape route validity property. Let's set this value to true. Please also note that the escape routing zone includes all the doors. The next step is to create a new criteria set with the help of the Find and Select. This criteria set will be used for filtering elements for collision detection later on. By using the Add button, we can select the applied ARCHICAD classification and then select Door. Now we can add the necessary fire resistance rating values. We would like to identify those doors that have fire resistance which is less than 1 hour. Therefore, we'll use the 25 minutes or 30 minutes values here. Let's save this criteria set and enter the name Door FR, meaning Door Fire Resistance. Let's see how to perform collision detection between the zones and the doors. Let's open collision detection. We would like to include all zones along the escape route in Group 1. We want to include all doors and fire rating properties in Group 2. Let's select the zone for element type in Group 1. Let's also add another criteria that will filter the zones in the project, because we need to consider only those zones, actually only those door elements within such zones, which are located along fire escape routes. Let's select the escape route validity property for criteria. Let's also specify its value as true. We'll select the door FR criteria set in group 2. Let's press check to start the collision detection process using these criteria sets. ARCHICAD informs us that two doors were found. We can use the markup tools to find out more about the doors that have a fire resistance rating value of less than 1 hour. Thanks to the markup tool, not only can we review the colliding elements, but we can also edit these as well. The color pink indicates those elements that are identified by collision detection. Once we switch on the display of the clashes, let's have a closer look at both clashes. We'll correct the fire resistance rating of both elements using their settings dialog. Once both fire rating values are corrected, we can remove these entries from the markup palette. Please make sure that no elements are selected in the design, because these will also be removed together with the markup entries. We can create BCF files using ARCHICAD's markup tools. With the evolution of BIM as the de facto workflow, architects increasingly receive consultant information in a BIM format. To help architects fulfill their role as lead coordinator, ARCHICAD's collision detection allows two groups of elements to be compared through user-defined criteria sets. These criteria sets can include element types, classification values, property values and attributes, such as layer names or building materials.